एंड हेल्थ चैप्टर 3 क्लास 5 क्वेश्चन आंसर। क्वेश्चन डी, आंसर दीज क्वेश्चंस इन ब्रीफ। क्वेश्चन 1, लिस्ट द फैक्टर्स दैट डिटरमाइन द अमाउंट ऑफ न्यूट्रिएंट्स नीडेड बाय अ पर्सन। द आंसर इज अमाउंट ऑफ न्यूट्रिएंट्स नीडेड बाय अ पर्सन डिपेंड्स ऑन देयर एज, हेल्थ एंड जॉब। According to their age, health and job. If the person is children, then they take less amount of nutrients. And according to health, if the person is ill, then he take different types of nutrient. And according to job also, manual laborers need more carbohydrates as compared to office worker. Now question 2, what is meant by deficiency diseases? Answer is diseases caused due to the lack of one or more nutrients in the diet. If in the diet one or more nutrients are lacking or less, then we have deficiency disease. Example of deficiency diseases are scurvy, beriberi, rickets, night blindness, marasmus, etc. Question 3. How can the deficiency diseases be cured? Very simple question. Answer is also very easy. Deficiency disease can be cured by providing the deficient nutrient to the patient. The deficient nutrient which cause the disease, if it is given in the diet of the patient, then this type of diseases can be cured. What are communicable diseases? Give an example. Answer is diseases which spread from one person to another or from an infective organism to another. They are called communicable or infectious disease. Communicable or infectious disease, these are caused by the germs and spread from one person to another. For example, corona. Example of communicable disease are cholera, typhoid. Cholera and typhoid, these are communicable disease. If some person has cholera, then from the infected person, it can be spread to the healthy person. Now, question E. Answer these questions in detail. First one is, how do communicable diseases spread? Answer is, communicable diseases may spread through, first is infected person, direct contact with the person suffering from communicable disease. If someone is in direct contact with the person which already has communicable disease, then the person who is in contact get also the same disease. Second is through food or water. Flies and mosquitoes sit in dirty places and spread the germs through uncovered food or water to the food and water. Through air, germs in the air may enter the body through coughing, sneezing or spitting. The germs may enter in the air and the person who inhales such air get infection. Now, question 2. Write 3 ways in which we can prevent communicable diseases. Answer is, ways to prevent communicable diseases are, first is keeping personal hygiene and keeping surrounding clean. If we take care of our personal hygiene as well as hygienic conditions of the surrounding, then we can prevent communicable diseases. Second is using disinfectant and throwing garbage in the covered dustbin. Time to time, we have to spray disinfectant in our houses as well as we have to use covered dustbin. Third point is our houses should be airy, allowing in ample sunlight. If our houses is airy, means cross ventilation is there and proper sunlight enter in our house, and sunlight, this is a natural disinfectant. so it can kill the germs and we can remain protected from the communicable disease. Now the question third, this is very interesting question. What is the balanced diet? Now prepare a balanced diet for your lunch. A diet, answer is a diet containing all the essential nutrient in the correct amount. This is called balanced diet. Now balanced diet for lunch, this include carbohydrates. Carbohydrate means cereals and grains. Cereals and grains like wheat, rice, maize, barley, bajra, etc. So this should be 175 gram, means 2 chapati. In lunch, we have to take 2 chapati. Second nutrient is proteins. Proteins means fish, egg or dal, any pulse we can take. 60 gram. 60 gram means 1 bowl. 1 bowl. Fats, butter, oil, ghee, etc. Only 40 gram, means 2 spoon. 2 spoon butter. And next is vitamins, fruits, vegetables. So these are very small amount, 0.081 gram, or we can say 1 in number. Now dietary fibers, that are whole grains, which we have to take 20 gram, or we can say 1 spoon. Now minerals, so that may also include sprouts, and that is also 10.20 gram, or we can say half bowl. So that is a balanced diet for our lunch. Now the question number 4. What is hygiene? How can we maintain hygiene to stay healthy? Hygiene means cleanliness of oneself and our surrounding. Cleanliness of personal and surrounding. So that is hygiene. So we can maintain hygiene by, first we must bath daily to remove sweat from our body and keep ourselves free from germs and dust. By bathing, we feel good. Second point is, we should wash our hands with soap and water before eating food and after going to toilet. Third point is, we should brush our teeth twice a day. At least 2 times we have to brush our teeth. First in the morning and second before going to bed. You can add any other points to stay healthy, like we have to wear clean clothes daily and we have to comb our hair regularly. We have to trim our nails regularly. So these are the some points which we have to keep in mind for maintaining hygiene. Bye children, have a nice time.